Recording.
Hello, everybody.
Hi.
Welcome. This is the Westlands. And we're doing another react video. We ain't done one in ages, have we?
No. We've had time off, haven't we? To record a million songs.
We did, yeah. We literally not a million. It wasn't quite a million. It was close. We have recorded a lot. We've been writing a lot. We've been playing a lot of shows as well, Em. Isn't that cool?
Yes, it has. We've been busy, busy bunnies, haven't we?
Yeah. And the last show that we played at the station in Cannock, you know, I haven't been there in ever, and I've been there twice in a week, so that was cool. It's a cool venue based in Cannock. If you've never been there, it's really, really good. I enjoyed it. Great crowd on Saturday. It's always weird when you're playing to someone else's audience.
You never know what you're going to get on stage, do you?
No, exactly. And you never know what you're going to get in the audience either, because you kind of don't know whether they're into your kind of music. We were supporting Lawrence Jones and Blue Nation, who are a bit different to what we do. Yeah. But yeah, it went down great and the feedback has been amazing. So thank you, everyone that came to talk to us at the show. We are going to be doing a reacts to video today to
Shania Twain, Giddy Up.
Giddy up, yarr.
Giddy up.
And if you like new music and you like anything that we do, please hit the like button, subscribe to the channel as well, because that's really helping us out. We're up to 151 subscribers now, which has grown loads in the last like 2 weeks. Got like 63 new subscribers. And if you got any comments, bang them in the comment section. Get involved. Let us know what you think. As you can see, this is our YouTube channel where we've got...
Oh, isn't it pretty?
It is pretty, isn't it?
Yeah.
we've got... I'm just going to put you over there on this screen. So if I keep looking over there, people, that's why I'm doing it. Yeah. Somebody in the previous video asked me as well why we have the YouTube screen so big and our face is smaller when it's meant to be a reactive video. I'm afraid that's just the software that I have. There's nothing I can do about it. So apologies. And plus, you don't want to see this all in 4K up in your face.
Not at 20 past nine on a Monday night. Oh,
also, big thanks to everybody that's checked out our new single, Falling. Awesome. Thank you very much. It's just hit over 1,000 views. So we're going anyway. Shania Twain.
Giddy up. I love that.
I have to say it like that every time.
Giddy up.
All right, here we go then.
Giddy up.
In this quick video, I'm gonna show you
we've got some adverts. Another plugin or MIDI pack that someone's trying to sell me. All right, here we go. Oh, hang on a minute. My internet's decided to freeze. Let's just give it a second to buffer.
Like we're back in the 90s.
I left my heart at a watering hole somewhere in small town Ohio. Headed out west to Arizona, cause the East Coast weather's too cold, cold, cold.
Sorry, I don't normally stop a song that early. Is it me? Is there a crazy amount of auto-tune on a vocal?
Possibly, but I don't care! Play it again!
Okay. I left my heart at a watering hole somewhere in small town Ohio.
I think there is a hint of auto-tune.
A hint. Shit, it doesn't even sound like her.
Oh my God. That's the best sound like I've ever heard.
Right, I couldn't really listen to that properly then because I was just so, I was just the whole time I was listening to it, I was just thinking that doesn't sound like Shania Twain. They're just,
no.
Maybe I need to see past that.
How old is she now?
I don't know, but she's obviously, the thing is, it's difficult because you're trying to compete in a modern market where the industry almost expects a certain type of sound now.
Yeah.
But that was way over the top.
It was a bit poppy, wasn't it?
Yeah, just a tiny beat. I like the beat. I really like the up-tempo nature of it. I like the beat. I didn't pay any attention to the lyrics. So do you mind if I go back and just listen to it again?
No, because... I could listen to this all day.
I left my heart at a watering hole somewhere in a small town in Ohio. Okay, right. So the lyrics already look pretty, you know, country. So let's just go for this. This is not, didn't feel that country over there. It's got like a bit of a vibe, westerny vibe about the video, but just felt like a proper pop track to me. Yeah. Let's just go, let's just dive into it.
I got a fast car with the 90s on, not a soul on the roof, but the road is home. Smiles for miles, all up on my bed. Wait, yeah, cause we ain't got time to waste. Get to it. Up in the giddy up, giddy, giddy up, up in the giddy up. Drunk in the city, got a lady in the cup, up in the giddy up.
Like Glee.
I don't think a song has ever made me so happy. Oh my word. What is this? This is brilliant. This is what you allowed to. Did you just spray that across your living room?
I'm trying not to. And it's Pepsi as well. So it's... Oh, it's hurt my nose. Why is this so funny?
Right, okay. I did pay a bit more attention to it. I actually quite like the lyrics are pretty good, to be fair. It is very upbeat. It's meant to be fun. It's obviously working because we're laughing and we're having fun. So we're not laughing out of disrespect. I think it's
shock. This is incredible. Oh, my eyes are watering.
I think it's more out of shock.
It's just, this is the one who's, you know, you're still the one I run to. Giddy up, giddy up. I love it.
Can we do a cover of this?
Oh, I'd love to see you sing this.
I'm wearing them hot pants she's got on now.
Sold.
Oh, we're gonna get hate for this. Right, okay, right, here we go. Right, please, we're not being disrespectful. We just, the song has made us very jolly, and for some reason it's tickled us both. If anyone else feels the same, let us know in the comments. I've lost it now. Right, let's get back to the song. Jesus Christ.
And I make it happen cause it feels so good. Singing in the mirror like it's Hollywood. Life is getting shorter, gotta drink it up. Time to shine like I know you should. Slide to the left, then slide to the right.
Bit of a line dancing song.
Dog's going mad downstairs. I think she wants to join in.
I like this pre-chorus.
Yeah, it's nice.
Okay, I get it now. It's a song for TikTok, isn't it?
Yes, I think you're right.
So Shania Twain's gone, right, okay, I've got to release a new album. I've got to appear young. I've got to hit the young market. We need to come up with a song with a dance routine.
Yeah.
So it goes massive on TikTok. Let's go and I'm going to have a look on TikTok in a sec.
Yeah, your TikTok's more likely to find it than mine.
I don't know where, but I guarantee that this is...
Everyone!
I guarantee this is all over TikTok. Let me just find Giddy.
I wouldn't know how to check for this. I'm a bit old school.
I've just typed in giddy. First thing that comes up is Giddy Up Dance.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's absolutely, yeah, look. It's full of it. It's all, oh, everybody, yeah, doing the dance routines.
Bravo, Shania Twain. Bravo.
Well, it was either her or a PR team or someone who's come up with that idea. It's a good idea, though. I'm not knocking it at all. I mean, if I was the kind of person that could write these really upbeat, chirpy songs, all our songs are a bit sad.
Between the two of us, we can't, I think we've got a chirpy song between the two of us.
Let's get back to the song. We keep coming away from it. Right, let's go back just a tiny bit and then go into the next bit. Looks hot, though.
Yes, there we go. Bit of line dancing.
Ah, some la-las. La-la-la-la-la.
Oh, very nice. Somewhere in small town
Ohio. I like the guitar.
Arizona, yeah. Cause the East Coast when there's some cool, cool, cool. Easy come, easy go. I got a fast car with the 90s on. Not a soul on the road, but the road is home. Up in the giddy up, giddy, giddy up.
Oh, it's such a TikTok song.
I will not be doing this dance routine.
Oh, yeah. Get in the comment section now. Should me and Emma do a TikTok? Should we do a TikTok rendition of this dance routine? We get the whole band doing it. Fuck it.
And should Steve be wearing a hot pants?
So deliberately done for TikTok, isn't it?
Yeah, that? It's brilliant. Marketing, this is absolutely brilliant. Does she have like 5 minutes? They say, Shania, we've got 5 minutes for you to record a video. Last, do you want to quickly appear in it?
I know. Yeah, that music video actually reminded me of "Happy" by Pharrell Williams.
Do you know? I was thinking that as I was listening to it, I also thought the sound of it was a bit reminiscent of "Happy" as well.
Hmm. Wonder who wrote it.
Shall I have a look for you?
Have a look. See who wrote it. Because she's on Republic Records, UMG.
Shania Twain was one of them. Dave Stewart. Dave Stewart is in Dave Stewart, Dave Stewart.
Well, I'm pretty sure that probably is his name, yeah? Dave Stewart is in
started as my
Fred West. Yeah, that guy.
Could no, he's in Dave Stewart. What was he in? Is he in Rhythmics?
I don't know.
Yeah, he's in the Rhythmics, Dave Stewart.
Oh, wow. Okay.
He wrote See, that. That's such a stupid question.
He co-wrote that.
Yeah, so Dave Stewart, Jessica A. Gombar, Romans, in all in capital letters, and then Shania Twain.
Super. Well, let's discuss. Okay.
Loved it. Oh, he looks like he's co-written a lot of this album because she used to write with Mutt Lange, didn't she? I think when they married, I imagine after the divorce, like things got a bit testy.
My knowledge of Shania Twain's career history, I've got to be honest, is a little bit. It's a little bit sketchy.
Yeah, I think mine's probably a bit better than yours. Yes, she used to write with Mutt Lange, who I'm pretty sure she was married to, and now he doesn't appear on any of these tracks. Shocker! Oh,
man. Okay, so let's talk about the track anyway, because we've laughed at it for about 15 minutes. So, it's a good song. Lyrically, actually, it's all right. I quite like the lyrics.
I thought it was a very bouncy little number, and I like it.
It was very happy. It was clearly does exactly what it says on the tin. It's meant, it's an upbeat, fun song. It's a TikTok trend type video. She's clearly
you spat your coke out.
She's clearly trying to hit a mainstream audience with it. You know, she's not like she's trying to go after old school country with this, is she?
No, I wonder what the rest of the tracks are like. Be interested to listen to the rest of the album.
That would be interesting, actually, because maybe this is the kind of track that gets the young kids to know who she is.
Yeah.
And then they drag them over, and then maybe there's some traditional stuff on the album. Don't know.
Yeah, we'll I wonder.
We'll have to have a listen. Guys, let us know what your thoughts are in the comments. That was a whirlwind, absolute whirlwind. I feel like that song just came on and then just hit me in the face with a bass.
How long was it? It was a very short track.
Yeah, it was like 2.5 minutes or something. It was pretty short.
Yeah, 2:42.
Yeah. Good. I'll tell you what I did particularly like. I really liked the sound of those acoustic guitars.
They were lovely.
Not just what they were playing, because that rhythm was catchy as hell. But I really liked the way they sounded. They sounded great, like really, really nice. High production value, even though it was like quite cheesy and stuff, everything that was going on musically still sounded super well produced, as you would expect, I suppose, for someone of that level.
It's so interesting how something like TikTok has brought dance routines back.
I was saying this the other day. Imagine some of the songs of old, like ABBA, the Bee Gees, and people like that, if they were released their music of then, now.
Yeah.
With the TikTok era. Imagine staying alive.
Here's an interesting little thing. So, as everyone knows, I have a proper job outside of this. I'm a teacher.
Oh, you're still doing that? You're not getting paid for this?
Not yet. And I'm organising at the moment. We're having to do our inter-house dance competition. So we're looking at dancing across the decades. And so we put on some disco music and a couple of kids knew a few disco moves. And I put on Run DMC, It's Like That, to try and show a bit of like hip-hop. And they were like, oh, I've heard the song. We tried to show them a few dance routines for a few different songs, got nothing. They started dancing to a TikTok song. The entire crowd, there was about 16, 17 kids there, got it straight away. They knew this TikTok. I'd never heard of this song. Still couldn't tell you what it was called now, but they all just started dancing along to it. And as soon as I played it through, they all knew the moves. And I thought, isn't that interesting?
How could we get people to dance to Falling on TikTok?
But please don't fall over and hurt yourselves.
In fact, couldn't people just here's an idea for everybody watching. Take our song. It's called Falling. Go check it out. It's on TikTok. If you type it in the audio, you'll find the song, right? Go get a video. Give someone a push.
Front page of the Sun tomorrow.
And then just loop it as a GIF and just kind of, I keep falling. And then just keep falling over like... don't give anyone a push, please. Oh god, the internet. Oh, I've just realized I said that on the internet. Someone's gonna give someone a push and I'm gonna get blamed for it.
Yeah, maybe we should just write an upbeat track like that and we'll try let's choreograph a dance routine to it.
Shall we try Well, I could get my Littlens dance school to do something.
That's it then.
That should be so cool.
We've set each other challenges in the past.
Let's do it Oh my god, we're gonna write a Giddy Up song. Can we call it Giddy Down?
Ride 'em Cowboy. No, that's a different song entirely. No.
7-year-old in his dance school. What are you thinking, woman?
No.
I think as well, I would like to do another video soon, if Emma's up for it, about the Grammys. That was interesting, wasn't it?
Oh. I love Brandi Carlile. We love her.
People seem to
be more
interested.
Big old gays did well at the Grammys.
People seem to be more interested in what people were wearing and people's sexualities than there was any music. I would have liked the Grammys to be about music, which would be quite nice because it's a big music award ceremony, but it seemed to be more about fashion.
Yeah.
No one seems to give a crap about the music. And a lot of the music winning Grammys, I'm sorry. Not a fan. I really like Harry Styles.
He's brilliant.
I like Harry Styles. He's a bit of a shithead though, because he just looks good in everything. He drapes himself in a curtain, the guy looks good. It's not fair. Yeah. And then poor Sam just trying to wear anything he can just to get some headlines. But you can wear whatever the hell you want, but it still has to suit you. You know what I mean? Like, Lizzo, how fantastic did Lizzo look, man? Like, she's like, she kills it every time. Every time. I love Lizzo. I read when she said, did her acceptance speech about Prince, and she said, I just want to dedicate my career towards making like positive happy music, happy music, and being happy. And she seems like a really upbeat, happy kind of individual. I mean, obviously, you never know behind scenes, dear, but she just seems to be full of positivity. And I can totally get on board with someone like her. She doesn't cause headlines in the wrong ways and stuff like that. But yeah, the Grammys now and all these music awards, it's the Brit Awards next week. And I'm just looking forward to everyone getting up to do their acceptance speech. And instead of doing an acceptance speech, they're all going to get up and give us their political views. Oh, it's all good fun. What do you think of award ceremonies? Have they lost their, have they lost the joy? I feel like
I think if we got nominated for one, I think I'd still go.
Yeah, be
I'd fun. Feel the joy. I'd giddy up the whole way there.
I would go more because I just want to see what goes on afterwards. I wouldn't be that bothered about the award.
Couple of beers in you.
Yeah, the only thing I like is that people like the music. And if that's 10 people, that's wonderful. If it's 10 million, even better, because obviously my bank pocket would feel the feelings. But I just think, yeah, just everybody get back to the... In the 80s, everyone dressed like a weirdo. Do you know what I mean? Everybody dressed crazy. Everybody wore funky stuff. No one was really talking about it. It was just all about the music. I mean, boy George, it's not this new glam clothing that they're all wearing. It's not new. So I don't understand why. I don't understand why it's such a big deal. I mean, like, what has it not been done before? People have just forgotten about Prince, Madonna, Michael Jackson, you know, Britney Spears, and all the rest of them that have gone before. Has everyone just suddenly forgotten about those people?
Okay. I'll have to watch it.
New generation.
We'll watch it, then I'll slag it off for you.
It's just a farce, man. I just like, it's like the Oscars with the, like, was it the Oscars or the Golden Globe? Which was the one where Will Smith
slapped someone?
So no one's talking about the Oscars. Everyone's talking about a slap. It just always seems to be something else to talk about other than the thing that they've actually gone there to get the awards for.
Yeah.
Just let everyone just do what they want to do and wear what they want to wear. And let's just talk about music. That's what this channel's for. So if you like talking about music, come over here. Or if you like laughing at music, like we are. Look, like we have done today.
I love it.
It's brilliant. It is catchy.
Yeah,
I'm definitely going to be singing that later in my sleep. Right, 22 minutes in, 23 minutes. Thank you very much if you've watched this video. If you watched it all the way to the end, double well done to you. If I could give a thumbs up to you, I would. But that is this. Oh, what the?
Steve, what is this? Just Pepsi, yeah.
Just Pepsi. Don't drink Pepsi, kids. See you later.
Bye.
Bye.